The UTV market continues to grow, and at AMSOIL, we love to test. So we went out and we got a 2023 Polaris RZR Pro XP Turbo, and we put it through its paces. We ran what we call at AMSOIL a proof of performance. That's where we go out and we collect field data as if the machine were to be used by a normal user. And then we turn up the intensity of that data and we get it on the dyno. So we need to understand oil temperatures, acceleration rates, max throttle. We put sensors on the oil sump, we put sensors on the coolant, boost pressure, temperatures of the transmission, temperatures of the CVT belt. So we build a run profile based on the data collected in the field. We then turn up the intensity, and in this case, it was turned up 10 to 15% depending on the run cycle. Total time for this test was 50 hours. That is the recommended oil drain interval for this machine. The oil being used, AMSOIL ATV UTV 0W50. Once the machine is on the dyno and running, it's a waiting game. We get through 50 hours of testing and it's time to take it apart and look at the results. So in this case, we'll be looking at the engine and the transmission. The pistons, crowns of the piston, minimal depositing, the under crown of the piston, no depositing at all. The piston looks almost new. This area gets very hot, so if you're going to see depositing, that's an area where you will see staining in a situation where the oil may not be doing its job. So in this case, they look excellent, perfectly clean. Valve guides look excellent, no abnormal wear, no depositing at all. The valves themselves, we pull those out for an inspection. We look at the stems, we look at the seats. They look excellent. There's no staining. There's no indications that the valves were carboned up and leaking, which can be the case. In certain situations where the oil may not be doing its job, you could get a piece of carbon that could hold a valve off its seat, and you might end up getting some kind of a leak. You start losing performance. In this case, everything looks beautiful. No issues at all. Valves were sealing perfectly. From there, you move to the cylinders. You can still see the cross-hatching in the cylinders. We're used to this at AMSOIL. We understand how these machines work. We understand how to build oil. So it's not surprising when we see really clean cylinders. That means that you're keeping the oil in that cylinder to keep everything lubricated. Everything is sealing. The engine retains the power that it had at the beginning of the test all the way through the engine's life. From the cylinders, we move to the valve train. We disassemble all the small parts of the valve train and we look at them individually. So you start with the camshaft. There's no sign of any wear on the cam. The lobes look great. The bearing journals look great. You move to the intake and exhaust lifters. They look great as well. Sometimes you'll see staining with an inferior product with excess heat. In this case here, everything clean, no staining, no wear. From there, we look at bearings. These are critical areas that tell you whether or not the oil is doing its job. If you are going to see wear in a turbo application, you'll see it on the upper shell of the rod bearing because you've got increased pressure coming down on that from the turbo. The case here, the bearings look as good as when we put them in. Main bearings are the same case. All indications are viscosity was providing protection required to keep this motor looking excellent. We look at oil analysis throughout the test. And in this case, we sampled every 10 hours. We have oil samples from 10, 20, 30, 40, and then 50, which would represent end of test. We track things like viscosity. How much does the viscosity change? We look at things like oxidation, nitration. Is there a fuel buildup problem? Are there things going on in the oil that would tell us that it's not doing its job? In this case, all of the results are positive. We are not seeing excess amounts of viscosity changed. The oil did not oxidize due to heat. We don't have a fuel dilution problem. And there's plenty of reserve capacity for this oil to continue to protect. We look at the wear metals from the same oil samples at the same drain interval, and there are no wear metals to report. So there are no metal parts touching, which is the oil's main job, is to make sure no metal parts actually touch. It's done that here extremely well. We have virtually zero wear metals across the entire 50-hour test interval. The transmission on the Polaris is a CVT, but there's still a gearbox to move the power from the engine through the CVT out to the wheels. So we do look at the transmission on this test. Transmission was tested the same amount of time. It was a 50-hour test. And at the end, we look at oil analysis and we do a full teardown, same as the engine. Oil analysis on the transmission is the same story as the engine. Very little to no wear metals, very little viscosity loss, indicating to us that the oil is more than up to handling the job, you know, even in this turbocharged Polaris. So the results are in. AMSOIL ATV UTV 0W50 performed flawlessly. We showed you the test. We showed you the results. And if you own one of these machines and you're out taking it to the limit, have confidence that AMSOIL has you protected.